I tell you, if you know how to be free from the knowns, freedom from the known, there is a beautiful book by Jay Krishnamurti, Freedom from the Known. If you know how to have the freedom from the known, only then you will know how to live spontaneously, like child. Children, they don't have any way. They don't have any way to live. They have just only spontaneity. We are so organized, we don't commit even a small mistake, but by the end, commit big blunders. Big blunder is what I call living organized life. You know, now in the West, in America, citizens are suing the government. Why? Because you created a lifestyle which makes us depressed. We are falling into depression because of your lifestyle. From the young age, you gave a type of education, you gave some type of lifestyle, you taught us to live in, you know, some way. Now that lifestyle is giving depression. Do something about it. They are suing, of course, in West. In America, you don't know, you can sue for anything. They are suing McDonald's company, the food shop. Because of your food only, we became fat. No, they are suing. And they are winning the case. And they sued the smoking companies, that cigarette companies. Because of your cigarette only, we got cancer. Why are you producing at all, first of all? They are suing and winning. That is why the many cigarette companies have went bankrupt in America. Now they are suing. What type of lifestyle you are teaching us? It is leading into depression. Because if among the three, 2% are depression patients in America. 66% are taking psychiatric medicines. Only in 2003, last year, in 365 days, 103 million depression medication prescriptions are issued in America. 103 million. And the beauty is, all the medicines have got the side effect of creating cancer in the body. All depression medicines have got potentiality to create a cancer as a side effect in our body. 103 million. Now they are suing the country. Actually, in Petrobras, there is one more discourse in a corporate company. Have you heard of the Petrobras company? None of you have heard? It is a leading five companies in the petroleum field. There are only among the top five companies, this company is also one, Petrobras. They wanted me to give a stress management discourse. I agreed. Then they said, if Swami comes without this dress, with a coat suit, it will be nice. I said, no, I don't want to give a discourse. If they want our wisdom, let them accept me as I am. They said that, it will look like religion. Some of their people came and attended my discourse in public. They requested, if Swami can come and give us a discourse, it will be really grand. I will be very happy. I said, I have no problem. I will come and give a discourse. I will come and speak to you all. Then they requested, it will be like too much religion if Swami comes with this dress. If he can change to suit, it will be nice. I said, if you want our wisdom, accept our culture also. If you don't want our culture, I am not ready to give our wisdom also. When I went there, there was a group of fanatic Christians. After the discourse, when I asked them to raise any questions, they asked, what you speak about your Indian culture? It is filled with the nonsense community system. Community system. What justification you give for the community system? You say about your culture such big way. It was a shocking question. And very damaging way they asked. Yeah, he put that question in a very damaging way. and just cunningness, logic. Somehow wants to pull. He put the question. I told him, community system is never created to make somebody low or to make somebody high. It is created based on the work duty done by them, based on the character on which they live. It is based on the guna, not based on the birth. It is based on the work. And nobody is higher, nobody is lower. We created communities based on intelligence. Man cannot live without communities. So we created communities based on intelligence. You guys created community based on money. Get into the aircraft and see the people who are sitting in the business class, how they look at you. As if you are untouchable. By very look, how they look at you. You have to cross the business class to go to the economy class. If you see the way in which they look at you, you can understand their community. I told them, we created community based on intelligence, giving importance to the purity and intelligence. You people created community based on money and status. With our system, we are able to survive 10,000 years. The system which we are practicing is alive more than 10,000 years. You guys created a system which is not standing more than 300 years. Already the whole society is in depression. Already the whole society is in depression. 66% are psychiatric patients. They say other 10% are called border people. Any moment they can derange, they can fall into the deranging mood. No, it is not my survey, it is their survey. 10% of the American population is in the border verge. Any moment they can fall. And not only that, in outside they will look exactly normal. They will behave very normal. But at some moment they will be almost psychics. They will be just vomiting their depression. They are called border people. 10% of the population is border people. Understand? It's not a small joke. Already your society is in depression. Our society has withstood last 10,000 years. And I think hardly 1% of Indian population is depression. We don't have the problem depression at all practically. Hardly 1%. Of course, we have enough of poverty, enough of reasons to get depressed. But the depression medicines are used to only hardly 1% of the population. Only 1% of the population uses any kind of depression medicines at all, or sleeping pills at all. Where is 1%? Where is 66%? I told them, of course, we have made a community system, but see, who has survived? Who has survived? Our people are never put into depression. You have made a community system such a way, the whole society is in depression. At least I have seen, the kids' life in the West is the worst life. By the time they reach 12 or 13, they are pregnant. At least once they undergo abortion. At least once. It is not that I am telling rare incidents. A common incident. Common incident. And the whole thing is just because of the importance is given to logic and the organized way. If you see the West, there is nobody else. There is no other country can defeat to live an organized life. Their whole thing is organized. Whole thing is totally planned. That is why they have nothing else to do now, newly. Whatever can be done is done. Nothing else can be done. No new way. And you will be surprised in the airport. For some reason, because of some construction or something, they changed counter from one place to just 5 feet that side. The counter used to be here, just 5 feet they changed the counter, and they put a board also. For that, the customers have sued the company. How can you suddenly change? We do not know where it is, and we are searching. We know only this route. How can it change? And all these foolish things. Because regular, the organized. Don't be too organized. You will lose the charm of the life. You will get bored. Never follow any routine more than 6 months. Once in 6 months, change the routine. Do some alteration, some new way. Something, add something new. Remove something. Of course, sometimes there is no way, you have to go to the same office. But even going to the same office, make it some way delightful. Because 1/3 of your life is spent in working. Your working hours are duty or delight. Find out. Find out whether your working hours are duty or delight. Work on it. First, work on the working hours. How you can make it as a delight. If you can make the whole life as a delight, that is what really you can do. That is the greatest gift you can give it to yourself. Don't be so violent towards yourself by torturing it. Let you also have a little bit of life. Let you also have a new way of living. If you work on this third eye, you will be continuously creative and you will be living a new life. The third eye is the energy center which can create a new understanding about the life. Not only that, your old prejudices will be totally broken. Will be totally broken. It is a highly powerful mystical energy center which can change your life. As on now, 80% of your energy is wasted in the waste unnecessary thoughts. Only 20% of the energy is used in creativity. If this chakra opens, 80% will be used in creativity, 20% only will be used in unnecessary thoughts. That is why I tell you, this energy center can change your life. Let us work intensely on the Ajna Chakra. Before entering into the meditation, I wanted all of you to come near. Have you heard of this report? They say that the Ajna Chakra is 6 times more active than a normal human being. The frontal lobe, the decision making authority. This area is the, according to neurology also, this area is the decision making authority. Frontal lobe, they call it. That is what we call Ajna Chakra. That is 6 times more active than a normal human being. Normally, if it is 1.5 times active, you will become a scientist. And the moment the doctor came out after the PET scan, he said, "Swamiji, nobody can stay with you." I asked, why are you telling? Because if it is active 1.5 times, then even the 1.5 times active, the people will become scientists. You cannot live in here a scientist, actually. Because you will not be able to understand what he thinks. And you can never get along. Living with professors itself is a hell. Living with scientists is impossible thing. If you are living with a professor, then you can understand. Because in the house also, she will be continuously teaching. Or he will be teaching. Of course, continuous instructions. So it is difficult. And with 1.5 times, if it works, with that type of person itself, we cannot live. It is 6 times more active. How people are living with you, Swamiji? I said that you have to ask them. Anyhow, please come near. I want people with eye problem can come forward. If you have the glasses or contact lens, please come forward. Instruction very carefully, because it is a very subtle technique but powerful. Anything powerful is always subtle. First thing, you will be doing this meditation in two ways. One is closing your eyes and opening your eyes. When you close your eyes, concentrate deeply on your third eye. Imagine as if you are drilling it from inside, inside to outside. Imagine as if you are drilling it by your consciousness from inside to outside. When I say open your eyes, open your eyes, look through your third eye. Please don't look through these two eyes. Look through the third eye. Visualize, imagine as if you are looking through the third eye. Even after opening the eyes, you just feel you are looking through the third eye. And automatically these two eyes will get inserted towards the third eye. Look through the third eye to my third eye. Look through your third eye to my third eye. When I say again, close your eyes and penetrate your third eye. This cycle we will repeat. You understand? Any doubt in the instruction? Kanna moodi, rendu tharam pananuma. Kanna moodi pannum poludhu, kanna moodi, inda moonavathu kanna aalndu ullarndu paarunguma. Drilling pandra maadhiri, ulla totally concentrate pannunga. Kanna therakkum poludhu, அந்த மூணாவது கண் வழியாக என்னுடைய மூணாவது கண்ணை பாருங்கள். நான் அந்த புட்டு வச்சிருக்க இடத்த பாருங்கள். மூணாவது கண் வழியாக பார்க்குறீங்கன்னா இந்த ரெண்டு கண்ணை தானாக அப்படியே மேலே சொருகிடும். அந்த நிலை குத்துறதுன்றாங்க இல்லையா, அந்த மாதிரி கண்ணில் கண் வந்து மேலே சொருகிடும். அதுக்கப்புறம் திரும்ப கண்ணை மூட சொல்லும்போது கண்ணை மூடி திரும்பவும் அந்த மூணாவது கண்ணை அழுந்து பாருங்கள். அவ்வளோதான். எனி டவுட் இன் த இன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன்? That's all. Again, when you close your eyes, look to your own third eye. Penetrate your own third eye. That's all. No doubt. Any doubt in the instruction?
Shall we already open the eyes or just imagine?
No. You have to open the eyes. When I say open your eyes.
First, we have to just look through our eyes. Second step is
When I say close your eyes and look through your third eye. Look into your third eye. When I say open, open your eyes and look through your third eye to my third eye.
The power is too much, so we will not be able to see it clearly.
No, use the specs. That's good. Use the specs, don't worry. Otherwise you will be seeing somebody else's eye. The lady entered into the cabin and asked, Doctor, do I need glasses? The man replied, surely ma, because it is a barber shop. So let that not happen. Please close your eyes. Close your eyes and work on your third eye.